today, and so we are glad to have you joining us online as your young people continue to journey towards New Orleans. For those of you who are members of Holy Trinity who might not have gotten the memo and walked in today and are like, who are all these maize wearing shirt people? And this is maize, by the way. It's not yellow. It's maize. We could go into a whole thing about maize and blue, but then we could start drifting. We're not going to do that. Focus, Gromberg. We're here. All right, it's great to be here. My name is Eric Gromberg. I serve as the Bishop of the Northern Texas, Northern Louisiana Synod, of which Holy Trinity is a member congregation. I've been blessed to be amongst you several times over the years, but today is special because I'm part of a group that are traveling to the ELCA Youth Gathering in New Orleans. We have two groups, in fact, joining us. Slow down. Am I getting too anxious? Good. Let this be a lesson to you, young people. Even the bishop gets anxious sometimes because I'm excited. So we are grateful for all the leaders who have made this possible. We have Calvary and Advent Lutheran Church that are traveling as a group. And then we have a group of young people who are traveling as part of the bishop's group that are from various congregations. All of those young people's names are in the back of your bulletin and the congregations that they are connected to. And that is a gift you are giving to us because we have taken over your church for the last 3 days. And we are grateful for the hospitality that we've received. They're going to talk a little bit about what they've done serving here in Shreveport and in that community. And we're going to lead worship. So we're grateful to all of our young people as they lead worship. But before we do that, we have one announcement we need to make. Some of you know the gentleman standing to my left. Justin Gould has been a member of St. Stephen's here in Shreveport for many years. Justin has now become a member here of Holy Trinity. He is going to be applying to enter candidacy, the process by which we work towards ordination in the ELCA. And we are looking at him being a synodically authorized worship leader here at St. Stephen's as he does that candidacy and seminary work. He will be your worship leader and eventually, we pray, your pastor. And we are grateful to God for that. And I know, Justin, you have a couple announcements as well.
Yes. Good morning.
Good morning.
It's so wonderful to see all of you youth. I've been excited knowing all week you were coming and going to be a part of this congregation leading our service today. Welcome. Thank you. Now to the members of Holy Trinity. You know, last week in the announcements, I asked everyone to prayerfully consider signing up on the flower calendar. And I want to say thank you for everyone who has prayerfully considered that. And please continue to do so. The flowers on the altar are very important. Also, today, after service, the church will be feeding the youth lunch. It's not a Holy Trinity luncheon today. I do apologize. I know you came to church expecting lunch to celebrate with the kids, but today, unfortunately, the church will be providing lunch for the youth. So, I'm sorry, that's a sad announcement. Anyway, one last thing. Let's just rejoice and pray today as the youth travel for safety, for provisions, and that everything that they learn, things that they've done for us, which we're grateful for everything you've done, but we do pray your safe travel and learning and growth and look forward to you being the leaders of the future.
Thank you, Justin. Again, thank you all for your hospitality and for this community. We begin our service with words of confession and forgiveness. Annie Marley, if you'd come forward, I'd invite you to stand as you are able.
Holy God, open us to the presence of your Spirit. We are in need. We are in need of your mercy. God is our light and our salvation. Whom shall we fear? Christ shines through our unique gifts, giving glory to God. The Spirit transforms us through God's Word, renewing Christ's presence among us. God is calling us to live to lives of justice, following the examples of Jesus. Guided by the Spirit, we love others as God loves us. Sisters and brothers in Christ, we trust in a loving God who frees us from sin and frees us from the power of death. By grace you have been saved through faith, so that you might live a new life in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Blessed be our God, who makes us brave, who claims us with authentic love, who disrupts us with holy justice.
Amen.
Trusting in the promise of faith and rising together as a faithful community, let us confess our sin before God and one another. Holy One, we admit that it is easier for us to ways of doing things are better than yours. We hear that you love us, but we don't always know how to trust in you. We hear your desire for us to love each other, but it feels too scary when people look and act differently than we do. Search our hearts. Forgive us for the harm we have done to others and to each other.
Siblings in faith, God has created us to be a part of Christ's mission of compassion, mercy, and justice. Through the grace of his promise, you are forgiven and set free to live and to love as you are loved. Amen. Thanks be to God.
O Lord, you have searched me and know me. You know when I sit down and when I rise up. You discern my thoughts from far away.
You search out my path and my lying down, and are acquainted with all my ways.
Even before a word is on my tongue, O Lord, you know it completely.
Where can I go from your spirit, or where can I flee from your presence?
Is there anywhere else I can go to avoid your spirit, to be out of your sight?
If I ascend to heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in Sheol, you are there.
If I climb to the sky, you are there. If I go underground, you are there.
If I take the wings of the morning and settle at the farthest limits of the sea, even there your hand shall lead me, and your right hand shall hold me first.
The fact. The far western horizon, if I am beginning to miss, there are no
If I say, surely the darkness shall cover me, and the lights around me become night, even the darkness is as light to you.
I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your work that I know very well.
I thank you, my God. You are breathtaking. Body and soul, I am marvelously made. I worship and adoration, what a creation.
My frame was not hidden from you when I was being made in secret, intricately woven in the depths of the earth.
Search me, O God, and know my heart. Test me and know my thoughts. See if there is any wicked way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting.
Word of God, word of life.
My name is Lincoln Swanyard. I'm 18 years old. I just graduated. I come from a small congregation called Our Redeemer Lutheran Church. This past week, while waiting for our shower time at the mission trip site, a woman approached us with a kind offer. She invited us to use her fishing rods and bait, even though we were strangers. Her generosity and openness reminded me of the Lord's love and hospitality, showing us how to love our neighbors without hesitation. Her simple act of kindness mirrored Christ's heart. Just as Jesus extended love and compassion to everyone, she welcomed us with open arms. This encounter highlighted that the Lord's image is often found in everyday acts of kindness, showing us that we are all connected as brothers and sisters in Christ. As we go forward, let us remember this lesson by seeing and reflecting the Lord's image in our daily interactions. We become living testimonies of His love and grace. Sometimes the simplest acts of kindness reveal God's presence and inspire others to spread His light in the world.
Hello, my name is Lily Proctor. I'm a junior in high school, and I'm from Calvary Lutheran in North Richland Hills. During this trip, I got to go to Food Bank of Northwest Louisiana, where we got to help those in need shop for groceries, in which we explained the process and were with them through every step. When they came in, they seemed like they looked down upon to be there, but when shopping with them, they saw the amount and different types of food they were able to choose from, which lightened their burdens. In Psalm 139, verse 12, David mentions, for darkness is as light with you. When those families came in for groceries, the view of life that they had had relates to the darkness David talks about. At the end of the time with them, I felt as if God was there to lighten the burdens that they were carrying, to show them the light in the darkness. This has opened my eyes to see how this opportunity to help others is something that I can do within my own community. So I want to encourage you to be the light in someone else's darkness.
Let me tell you why.
Let me tell you why.
He's a radical God. He made the earth and the seas and the stars and the sky. And he came to be a man and he came to die.
But he didn't stay dead.
Because he couldn't stay dead. And he rose from the grave.
So let's all applaud.
That's why.
He's a radical God.
Our first reading for today comes from Matthew, the 5th chapter. You are the light of the world. A city on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on its stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before men, and that they may see your good deeds and praise your Father in heaven.
Good morning. My name is Mason Proctor. I am a graduate senior, and I am part of Calvary from North Richland Hills. I interpret this as the teachings of God, Jesus, and Lutheranism, explaining that we are all different, but we are all connected under this one idea of being selfless and open to other people. This allows me to understand the world around me and see these teachings in real life. As I mentioned earlier, I'm from North Richland Hills. It's about 30 minutes outside of Fort Worth, Dallas area, and because of that, I've had many different experiences. However, these experiences and differences let me connect with other people, like Lincoln, who is from our Redeemer in Granbury, Texas. But these differences allowed us to create a connection that I consider meaningful. Our takeaway from this should be that even though we're all different and we come from all different aspects of life, it shouldn't stop us from making connections. And lastly, I want to thank you all because in allowing me to share my message to you all, this has allowed us to establish a connection I will be able to carry with me for the rest of my life.
All right, so before I begin, I'd just like to give a thank you to Janelle for making all of this possible. I'd also like to thank you as a congregation for inviting us into your space and giving us a warm welcome and probably the best hospitality we've experienced on a mission trip. And I'd also like to thank everyone here for just giving me an opportunity to speak in front of you. My name's Christian Haley. I just graduated and I'm from Calvary Lutheran in Richland Hills, Texas. And I want to share some experiences with you that I think resonate with this Matthew passage. So yesterday we got up bright and early at about 5:30 in the morning, and we volunteered at a community garden in downtown Shreveport. And we were welcomed with open arms, and we brought our own supplies to just help wherever we were needed. And a couple hours in, this woman showed up with her two young girls, and we welcomed them the same way we were welcomed. And we let them help us, and we also shared our breakfast burritos with them. And I remember I took a teaching class in high school, and one thing I'll always remember my teacher telling me is that the best relationships are built over food. I don't think anyone's gonna disagree with that. But the important takeaway is, by being so hospitable and sharing our food with them, we created a connection with someone from another state that we had only known for a couple of hours. And by letting God's light shine through us, we created a lasting bond that I don't think those ladies will ever forget. Now, that being said, not every relationship we have with God is a positive experience. Last year, on June 24th, I got home from a mission trip, and I found out that my best friend had passed away in an accident. And immediately, my first instinct was to go back to the church and be with the people that I loved, many of whom I had only known for about a week. We had not only created a community, we had created a family, and I knew where I wanted to be at that time. And it was important to me that I was with those people that I had only known for a week. And we had created that relationship through God. We had let our light shine in the community in Kansas City for 7 days. I don't think I'll ever forget that moment. The important thing to know here is that God connects with us over food as well. Every Sunday, we share communion, we break bread, and we drink wine. And so I call you as a congregation to let God's light shine through you and create a lasting impact in your community. Thank you. Thank you.
Therefore, if anybody in Christ is in Christ, he is new creation. The old has gone, the new has come.
Hi, my name is Travis Adams. I'm going into my junior year this fall semester, and I am a part of Calvary Lutheran Church's congregation in North Richland Hills. Recently, on Friday, some of us, myself included, went to ARC. ARC is a day center and a preschool for adults and kids who have mental challenges. We worked with the adults in the morning and the kids in the afternoon. My favorite part was when we were at the preschool. Me and other friends dressed up as Winnie the Pooh characters and acted out a story for the kids to see. To see these kids with such joy lit up my day. Spending our time with these folks demonstrated our value for them, saying that they are people who are worth our time, just as anybody else. These people can often be looked down upon by others, but with this scripture and with Jesus' blood, they are made new. Just as they have been given purpose with us, Christ gives us purpose with him. Everything old has passed away, and everything has become new. So with these scriptures that we have, his purpose for us is to be a light in a dark world.
Hi, my name is Marcus Weiss. I'm going into my freshman year, and I'm from the Congregation of New Life in Christ. Today I'll be talking about how God helped me step out of my comfort zone and do things that I would have never done without God's help. I would have never gone on this trip without God's help and a little curiosity. Even though I've not been on this trip for very long, God has shown me how much fun something is when you have enough encouragement to do it. Just a couple days, I went to the ARC, a place for disabled people. When I first got there, I did not know how to talk or play games with any of the people there because I was afraid. Okay, now I lost where I was. I have a cousin who also has a mental disability. However, I still did not know how to talk to the people that was there. God gave me the encouragement to slowly start talking to each of the people with disabilities and play games and give high fives and fist bumps. Yesterday, I went to a community park and helped clean up and improve. When I got there, I wasn't too thrilled that I was working, but when I started working and cleaning up, I started to like it more and more until I didn't really want to stop until I was forced to. God gave me the courage to start working more, and that made me happy. In the Corinthians, it says, "So if anyone is in Christ, there is a new creation. Everything old has become new." God helps us do things that we never thought we could do. And the same is true for you when you are afraid or scared. You are God's new creation, and God has given what you need to keep going.
Thank you.
Let us confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father, Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, God's only Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and will come again to the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the life of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Captivated by the love of God, transformed by the hope of the resurrection, and the companionship of the Holy Spirit, let us join together in prayer.
You bear the burdens of our shared, fragile life. Expand our capacities to work together for the common good and an eagerness to ensure there's enough for all people to thrive. Bring hope, O God.
You are always making more room at the table. In your eyes, everyone belongs. Continue to ignite a holy hunger in us for building bridges in the world and in our neighborhoods. Bring hope, O God.
You do not shy away from those who suffer, but come to break the chains that keep us bound. Break the shackles that prevent us from responding to your call. Bring hope, O God.
You reach out healing hands and bear burdens of the sick, lonely, depressed, hurting, and heartbroken. Surround all who stand in grief. Give full measures of your resurrection hope this day to those who have suffered loss, especially. Bring hope, O God.
Trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Together with all those who hold faith in God, we receive the gift of peace. The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us share that peace. Greet one another in the name of the Lord.
As we return to our places, it's not printed in the bulletin, but we will be collecting an offering. So the ushers will come forward and pass the plates, and you are invited to share God's abundance for the work of this congregation, and we will enjoy some special music. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right to give our thanks and praise to our Lord God as we remember how in the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. He gave thanks, he broke it, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, he gave thanks, and he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this as often as you drink it, for the remembrance of me." Trusting in his word of life.
Remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. These are the gifts of God for you, the people of God. You will be invited by the ushers to come forward and to take a place at the altar rail. You can stand or kneel if that's more comfortable for you. You'll receive the host, the bread in your hand. If you require gluten-free, please let us know. We have wafers for you. You'll receive the host in your hand, and then you'll be invited to take a cup of wine, a small cup of wine, and then place that in the into the tray. All are welcome at the table. This is God's hosting, and we are under God's hospitality. Come, all has been made ready.
I am a woman who can die.
stand up there. You have that. Thank you. invite you to stand as you're able.
Let us pray. Lord God, when we work for change,
make us strong.
We who do new things,
make us brave.
When we challenge the world as it is,
grant us peace.
When we obey your command to love those who hate us,
give us faith.
Now send us out to be your people in the world, that we may tell the story of your love.
Amen.
May the Lord bless you, keep you. May his face shine on you and be gracious to you. May he look upon you with favor and grant you peace.
Amen.
Peace and serve the Lord.